Hello friends, this is Harinaganand in Moody, English Shorthand Instructor. To get more updates, please subscribe our channel. Our channel name is Shorthand Hub. Our channel is providing both general and legal dictations along with advanced outlines and dictations on current affairs to get a better speed in stenography. If you want to join in my WhatsApp group, please send a message to 970-4455-002. Now I am going to dictate a passage relating to shorthand at 120 words per minute, 5 seconds. Start. Significantly, PW4 also did not speak about the presence of PW5. According to the prosecution, PW6 and LW9 are not the persons in whose presence the appellants are said to have made the extrajudicial confession. In the cross-examination, PW4 stated that at the time when the appellants made the confession, the staff and sarpanch were not present, whereas PW3 deposed that the staff of the sarpanch's office were present when the appellants made the confession. According to PW4, about 4 or 5 people were present when the appellants made the confession. But according to PW3, there were about 70 persons at that time. PW4 claimed that they went to the police station and informed about the said confession, whereas the investigating officer denied that PWs 4 and 5 came to the police station and informed him about the confession said to have been made by the appellants. PW5 is another person who claims himself to be the recipient of the confession of the appellant about their culpability. According to him, when himself, PWs 3 and 4 were standing near the Gram Panchayat office, the appellants came and told them as to how they killed Kashi Ram. PW5 further deposed that the appellants asked them for protection and therefore the witnesses asked the appellants to go to their house, and thereafter they went to police and informed about the confession of the appellants. This conduct of PW5 is unnatural. When the appellants made the confession, if really PW5 was present at that time, he wouldn't have sent away the appellants and he would have gone to the police station to inform about the confession. That apart, as already stated, PWs 3 and 4 did not speak about the presence of PW5. According to PW5, the said confession was made by the appellants at about 8 a.m. in the morning. But according to PW3, the appellants confessed at about 5 p.m. in the evening. In view of the above facts, we find it difficult to hold that the evidence of PWs 3, 4 and 5 inspires confidence of the court for holding that the appellants approached them nearly 10 days after the alleged incident and confessed that it is they who have perpetrated the crime. As already stated, the other circumstance which is relied on by the prosecution to establish the nexus between the crime and the criminals is the confession said to have been made by the appellants, leading to recovery of the incriminating material objects. According to the prosecution, the appellants have, after having killed, robbed from him an earring, wrist ring and watch which are marked as MOs 4 to 6. As per the evidence of PW12, the inspector of police who investigated the case, the appellants were arrested on 3-8-2006 and in the presence of PWs 7 and 10 and MOs 4 to 6 were recovered at the instance of A1 to A3. PW4 deposed that on 3/8/2006, the police came to his house in the afternoon along with A1, and A1 confessed that he has hidden MOS-426 in the shed behind his house belonging to, and thereafter A1 produced MOS-426 which were recovered under Exhibit P4 Panchanama. In the cross examination, PW7 admitted that A1 confessed to the crime when the police and himself inquired him from whose shed MOS-426 were produced by A1 has neither been listed as a witness nor he was examined by the prosecution. According to the investigating officer, it is A1 to A3 whose confession led to the recovery of MOS-426, but PW7 is completely silent about A1 to A3's confession, which allegedly led to recovery of MOS-426.